Hey guys, in this tutorial I'm just going to show you how you can rig FPS arms inside Blender 2.8. For FPS arms I'm using a model that I have downloaded from Sketchfab. I will provide a link to download the model. So first I'm importing the model, which is in FBX format in the scene which I have modeled the gun. Make sure your gun is joined together, select all the parts and press Ctrl J to join different parts of the gun into a single object. Make sure your gun grip size matches the hands of your FPS arms. Now to create an armature, press Shift A and select single bone which will be in armature. It will show up where your 3D cursor location is. Press Tab to enter into edit mode and press Shift D to duplicate the bone. Now with the selected bone, press E to extrude the bone. Properly position the bones and make sure that the bones are positioned inside of the mesh, as it will help you to have better binding or rigging of your bones with the mesh. While positioning the bones, I change the viewport to orthographic view, first to the front and then to the sides. You can also change it to the top or bottom. It's useful to position the bones inside of the mesh. You can also reposition the bones by selecting them and by pressing G on your keyboard. But if you select the end spheres of bones, you can also change the location of their ends. After creating the finger bone, select the sphere of elbow bone and extrude it out. It's up to you whether you want to extrude up or just to the side of its position. Now press C and select the finger bones with the tendon bones and press Y to separate them. Also do that to the extruded bone, which I call as the wrist bone. After that, select the shoulder bone and the very first bone, which you can also call as the root bone, and press Ctrl P to select keep offset to make root bone parent of the other selected bones. Now do the same and make the wrist bone parent of the tendon bones, so that we can control the position of all the bones by only changing the root bone. Go to the pose mode and then select the wrist bone first and then elbow bone. If you press Ctrl Shift C, you can get the menu of constraint. Then select the inverse kinematic from the menu. You can also use constraint from the bone constraint tab and select inverse kinematic from there. So now if I change the position of the wrist, the whole arm will follow it. But we need to keep the rotation of the root bone or not influenced by the movement of the wrist bone. So in the constraint tab, change the chain length to 2. In this way, the root bone will not change its rotation if we change the wrist location or rotation. You can also apply copy rotation constraint to the fingertip bones. Therefore, you don't need to change every single finger bone while changing the hand pose to a grabbing pose. So change the world space in the bone constraint to local space. If it doesn't rotate in the angle you want to rotate, then go to bones constraint tab and then you can apply limit rotation constraint, and in the same manner change the space to local space and uncheck x-axis. If it doesn't rotate in the angle you want, then go to the edit mode and press N, and in the sidebar change the roll value while selecting the bone and match the one side of the bone rotation to rotation of the finger mesh so that it can rotate in the direction a finger rotates. You can also apply the same constraint to the other bones, but if you want to animate the finger manually, you don't need to apply these constraints, but these constraints will help you to animate fast. In edit mode, press Ctrl B and click and drag with the right mouse button and select the whole arm bones and then Shift D to duplicate the arm. And press Ctrl M to mirror on the opposite axis of the arm. Press X, Y, Z according to the situation. Go to the object mode and first select mesh and then the armature. Then press Ctrl P and select automatic weights. If your mesh has very good topology, it will automatically apply the weight painting to the mesh for the bones to bind with the mesh. Now select armature and change the object mode to pose mode. Then you can check and see the mesh is now attached with the bones, and now you can pose the mesh. For the gun, press Shift A and then select the bone from armature and then go to edit mode and then duplicate the bone and make bones for every functional part of your gun. For this gun, I have made bones for trigger, gun cylinder, base pin, yoke, hammer, thumb piece, and for every bullet of the gun, make sure that you name the bones according to the parts name of your gun. You can name them by going into the object data tab and then click the bones name and name it according to the gun part. After that, select the gun, go to the modifier tab and apply armature modifier. Click object inside armature modifier and select the armature of the gun. After that, go into the edit mode and then in object data tab, click the plus sign which is under the vertex group. Double click the group name and change its name to a bone that you made for the gun. Then select the part from the viewport by hovering over the gun part and press the L key to select that part, and then in the vertex group click assign to assign that part to that bone. Make sure you unhide all parts of the gun and second, there is no other part selected while assigning the vertex group. Now do same to all parts of the gun, select the part and name the vertex group and assign them with the bone's name. Make sure there is a parent bone of the gun which can move all bones. After that, select the parent bone and go to the pose mode and apply child constraint and select the FPS arm armature and select the root bone of the FPS arm inside child's constraint and click set inverse so that if we move FPS root bone, it will move the gun too. Now go to object mode and select both armature and change object mode to pose mode. Now apply child constraint to both of the wrist bones and select the gun armature with the gun root bone. So if we move or rotate the gun root bone, the whole arm will follow the gun. So now this rig is ready for the animation part, and that's pretty much about rigging FPS arm and gun. I hope this tutorial was beneficial for you guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can also get the project from my Patreon page. In the next tutorial, I will be going to show how to animate with this rig. I'm also providing a link to download FPS arms that I have used for this tutorial. So download it, follow my tutorial. Thanks for watching.